Life is on the edge for this despondent man. Just a metre from a deadly 53-metre drop over Niagara Falls. One single tiny slip from the point of no return.
You could hear 1,000 voices saying, oh my God, he's not gonna make it.
The man had gambled away much of his family's money. He had waded into the water to end it all. The bone-chilling water is just above freezing. He may have changed his mind about taking his life, but he can't save himself from the current.
No one's ever been that close and survived.
Cameraman Harry Rossitani's heart races as he takes in the scene.
All the elements were against the rescuers, the winds, the force of the water, everything. Niagara Falls is complex.
He was in such a precarious spot that we knew that every second counted.
I'm thinking to myself that hypothermia is going to kick in any minute now.
Pat Moriarty of the New York State Park Police and Niagara Falls firefighter Gary Carella were the first rescuers to brave the icy water.
These are the identical suits that they wore that day.
Officer Chris Gerlach was in charge of their rescue gear.
The cold water rescue survival suit is a 100% neoprene suit. The suit, when worn, is designed to keep water out, meaning it's a dry suit. It's not designed to have water under it, and this will keep you from getting hypothermia.
But hypothermia may have already set in for the man on the brink, who is wearing no protective clothing. As Pat Moriarty wades closer, he notices the man is shaking uncontrollably.
You get the shakes because your body's trying to generate heat, and then your extremities start to get numb because your body is shifting that blood to your core area to take care of your lungs and your heart and your vital organs. Then you go into severe hypothermia, where you can go into a shock, or you could actually have cardiac arrest. And when that happens, he goes down in the water, and it's all over.
It almost feels like there's an earthquake below you. We're tethered from our back and along toward the shore, and my legs are becoming exhausted just trying to maintain my balance. You feel that thunder underneath your feet. So you're thinking to yourself in your head, how's this gentleman standing there?
Although the man lost a lot of money gambling, he did have at least one stroke of luck. Just before reaching the edge, his foot got caught on some rocks, and that's why he wasn't swept away.
There was a rock that he was able to kind of wedge his feet under that kind of split the current and deflected most of the force of the falls away from this gentleman.
But rescuers know that foot can slip at any second. An emergency call goes out to the Niagara River Control Center to redirect the flow and reduce the force of the water.
The Sir Adam Beck plant draws its water immediately from this point, and the New York Power Authority plant draws its water about a mile upstream from this point. That operation affected the flow to go lower, less water through the open area at the end of the control structure, and a reduced flow at the falls themselves.
I think it made all the difference in the world. I think if it had stayed high the way it was, that water would have pushed him right over the edge.
Captain Kevin Caffrey and his chopper crew are the trembling man's last hope. But a helicopter rescue adds new risks.
The rotor wash looks tremendous. It's in excess of 100 miles an hour.
And just as Captain Caffrey closes in with a life belt secured to a rope, the rotor wash knocks the man off his feet.
I backed off, and as soon as I backed off, that's when he fell over. We figured he was a goner. Matter of fact, I said to my partner over the intercom system, I said, that guy's gone.
But as the chopper whips around, there's a shock.
See his legs go over the brink of the falls. And what he had done is, when he fell, he reached in and grabbed the same crack in the rocks that his feet were in. And then he popped his head up, and I locked eyes with him, and he was saying something to us. We found out later on, he was screaming, please don't let me go.
The chopper swoops in. It's now or never.
We knew darn well we absolutely only had seconds. So I flew in real close, and then that's when Art Litzinger, who was in the back, threw the ring.
When he fell down, I fully thought he would be swept over the falls. His resilience was unbelievable. He managed to hang on in all that cold water, and then as the ring came past him, he had to let go of whatever he was hanging on to and go for the ring. And he did, and he got it.
But this battle of life and death is far from over. The raging torrent crushes the man against the shore and traps him under an ice shelf. Now the water races over his entire body. He's on his back, and they're trying to keep his nose and mouth out of the water.
It's almost like watching somebody being on a tow rope in a ski boat, where they lost their skis, but they failed to let go of the rope.
Witnesses sensing the end know he's in a terrible spot.
I thought, I don't shoot dead bodies, and I don't shoot death as it's happening.
Rescuers can't risk pulling him up, since the weak man could slip right out of the life belt.
Sergeant Moriarty made his way over. He was just able to grab this individual by four of his fingers, and that's all that stopped him from being swept underneath the ice and going over the falls.
I just grabbed onto his hand and pulled him as hard as I could, and I'm telling him, fight, try to kick your legs, and he's telling me, I can't, I got nothing left.
He's a slippery dead weight. The two rescuers know they can't pull him out by themselves. They struggle to get a rescue harness around him.
As we were able to work the upper torso of the victim out from underneath the ice, Gary got down in the water almost underneath him. He was able to work this ice rescue harness up around his upper torso and then cinch the two ends together with the rope going up to the shore-based personnel. We yelled to the top, start pulling, and the rescuers up on top pulled the victim and Gary up together over that ice shelf.
After two excruciating hours, he's out of the freezing water and safe from the deadly falls. He's rushed to hospital for physical and psychological treatment.
It really gets a gut feeling, and when you know that your efforts are the only thing that stands between that man's demise and that man's life, it really is a strong driving force.
That driving force turned the man on the brink, who thought he'd lost it all gambling, into one of the luckiest men on Earth.
If I had to make a guess on the chances of him surviving through this whole thing, I'd say it was 1,000,000 to 1 shot. I was absolutely amazed.